taking part in some workshops devoted to innovative way of thinking about byproducts and efficiency of raw material. So they finally invented 14 staff food test products, so new recipes with the leftovers or byproducts which were after food processing. Most of the ideas came from POMES after producing different kind of oils or juice. So it was also a vegetable or fruit POMES. And as I said in the morning, they made 14 new products. They even cooked it and designed the packages. And we made a promotion of this approach and this staff food test product by introducing these achievements during our press breakfast, which we had last year. But the interest among the entrepreneurs coming from small and medium-sized enterprises in our region, in the branch of agri-food sector, was not so huge as we could expect. We were talking to them during this press breakfast, why they don't consider to extend the range of the products which they offer for the market. Maybe this way they can find a new niche for some trends in food products which can be offered in our region. But, you know, it is very difficult to persuade someone when the business is going quite well, that the efficiency can be increased and that they can generate additional profit from that what was usually wasted. Moreover, as the students with the scientists of our University of Life Sciences have noticed, most of the byproducts which they examined were full of very valuable ingredients. So that was a kind of experiment showing that support for the local entrepreneurs and the agri-food industry is not focusing only on financial support, on calls, on financial policy instruments. It should be also targeting the awareness of the sector. So educational aspect is not only devoted to children, to youth, to next generation, as it was said before by our panelists, but it is also the matter for the entrepreneurs and for the whole sector. They should consider the technology as one which can be improved, not that one which is already existing. So it was also said that the waste problem is has very varieties, and we should have the holistic approach to that. So we decided to teach or announce that to our entrepreneurs in next steps. That's why we are thinking about a new program for limiting food waste and food losses in our region for coming 5 years. And there will be two directions. One is connected with redistribution of food, which already exists, so to say, that from being wasted. And the second approach is increasing the efficiency of raw material. So it is for saving food, which was produced by our farmers, because the Kapuska region is one of the best agricultural regions in Poland. That's why we are thinking about such approach too. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Alicia. It was very interesting and comprehensive. Michele, if we hear Alicia, she says, calls, money, it's not enough. We also have to invest in education. And also she pronounced the word innovation, being innovative. Would you argue, you who are in contact with a lot of stakeholders from your center, would you argue that the food waste strategy or policy of a region should be linked, or a municipality, should be linked to its innovation strategy?
We have to understand what are the competences of the authority you are working in. Regarding the municipality, we don't have competences on industrial policy or agricultural policy. What a municipality can do to boost innovation is to act as a facilitator between people working and between on the same issue. If I may say, we began the very first stakeholder meeting a long time ago in September 2017, and we wanted to involve as many actors as possible to boost cross-fertilization, okay, among enterprises, associations, citizens, school directors, to create a sort of melting pot of different professionalities and knowledge. Honestly, this experience was not very, didn't work actually. At that stage, we recognized that cross-fertilization did not work. Therefore, we decided to change our approach in order to, in order to organize the stakeholders and give them a stake, so that we actually divided them into different categories: those wanting to work in the transformation process, those wanting to work in the redistribution processes, and those wanting to work in the education. This has proven to be an effective strategy. Everyone recognized a stake in the work they were doing. And we did not promise any particular investment at that time, but then, or any particular financial support. Nevertheless, acting as a facilitator, putting people together and mapping the experiences already going in the territory has helped a lot to create a common ground, first of all, a shared knowledge, and this has helped to boost good ideas. Okay, for example, when we began to work on how to replicate the model proposed by the region Catalonia, Pesa y Pinza, in our region, we acted as a facilitator, so we promoted a protocol, okay, and among schools and among health agency, and in order to unify the knowledge under one umbrella, let's say, and this has helped a lot. So what we have learned actually in this period is that cross-fertilization does not always work, and holistic approach is, in our experience, a very nice word, but is not always useful, especially in very in our context, all right, where people are, let me say it, people are tend to be very jealous of their work, all right, of their role. So so basically, they were not really willing to share everything, and this has been one of the difficulties we have encountered in our stakeholder meetings. So holistic approach is fine, cross-fertilization is fine, stakeholders need to recognize a stake, all right? So an advantage, which is not only money, of course, but is visibility, for example, for businesses, and so. And this has boosted actually a lot of ideas, a lot of participation, let's say. We are still discussing, for example, we are still very interested in studying the opportunity to create some platform which might resemble those used in the industrial symbiosis. We have seen many examples in France and in the PACA region, in Region Sud. So discussion is still going on, let's say. And this has been quite a good result of our work. And so this is our experience, actually.
Many thanks, Michele. That was very interesting, very up to the point. You have to deal with real life, where stakeholders must have stake.
Indeed. When,
you have to take care of the different territories of these stakeholders. Huh? So that was very illuminating. Would any other stakeholder, panelists, who are also stakeholders, would any other panelists want to take the floor on this issue of how local authorities can boost innovation for food, combating food waste? Konstantinos, you have the floor.
Thank you. I would like just to remind that the question was how can the good practices coming from the local stakeholders of the project, including, of course, our other stakeholders that were involved during this project, could be further supported. So we believe that we have an internal discussion on this, and we believe that these practices, of course, can be supported through the development or the creation of new policy tools, never existed before in the agenda, in the regional agenda. And of course, that there will financially enhance the development and the expansion into other areas and through the creation of probably for international based clusters and of course the participation in them. And these clusters can also enhance the exchange of know-how. They can help our stakeholders or any other stakeholders in the other regions to gain access to the know-how that is of course needed to implement innovations. And finally, to help stakeholders to improve, to evolve, and of course, to expand these practices that could be considered as critical for the policy instrument.
Thank you for this contribution. Yes. Fred Vara. You have to unmute your microphone.
Sorry. Thank you, Pascal, and good afternoon to everybody. From the Catalan perspective, to support in a certain way from the local or regional, in our case, administrations, the good practices, the eco-innovations that are implemented by local stakeholders, we see these as a different options. We can envisage this issue, the support to the initiatives, from a knowledge development and diffusion or communication perspective. For example, we are working since a long time ago with the local regional authorities to help them, to provide them with a space for learning and exchanging experiences in different ways. For example, through a set or a collection of best practices that are on different websites. For example, in the Catalonia Circular Observatory website, there you can find specific good practices that are were developed both by local stakeholders, private and public ones. Then we also have a platform, the municipal waste platform, that also includes best practices of food waste prevention that were raised up by local administrations and NGOs. Also in the field of communications, we organize or we work together with other people in the organization of workshops and seminars. For example, next week on the 16th of October, which is the World Food Day, as you know, our Ministry of Agriculture organizes the annual conference on food waste prevention, and there will be a place to discuss good practices at local level. But also we, as the waste agency, are organizing a webinar on best practices at local level on food waste prevention on the 25th of November within the framework of the Platform of Municipal Waste and the European Week for Waste Reduction. So many spaces for communicating among, for letting everybody know about good practices in Catalonia, but also creating specific spaces in which they can talk to each other. For example, the stakeholder group from this project, the Eco Waste for Food project, has been a very good, powerful space in which good practices were exchanged among others, and in which the discussion, an open discussion among different people, different organizations, helped new proposals, new projects, new actions, the opportunity to raise and develop new opportunities that were, that I cannot imagine that could have been possible within without this space, this exchange space. We consider the stakeholder group so important that it will probably continue after the Eco Waste for Food period. So this will become a new governance body. And of course, another way of helping them, of supporting local stakeholders' innovations, is through allowing money for them. For example, we include food waste prevention already in the municipal waste prevention grants and the circular economy promotion projects grants. There's approximately about €500,000 every year that are dedicated to food waste prevention projects through these two grants. So many ways of supporting local initiatives concerning food waste prevention. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Alfred. That was a good example of a successful cross-fertilization exercise, and it's very heartening to see that this, these groups will continue after the project as a governance body. That's a very good achievement for the project. Thank you. And this leads me to the second question, really, which is about strategies. You've said, Alfred, that of course there is a lot of ways that local authorities can support the actors of food waste reduction in their innovative mind, if I may say so. But I would ask the panelists to think about, is it better to have the food waste issue specified and isolated by specific local or regional policies and strategies, or can it be managed well enough through more generic strategies like we've heard about circular economy strategies or whatever? So what is the granulometry that is most adaptive to the strategies of the local authorities to tackle food waste? Now, I don't know, Annette, if you would have an opinion on that?
Yes, thank you, certainly. I think it absolutely has to be addressed at a local level.
Vale.
Hello? Did you hear that? Can you hear me?
Yes, it's all right. If you can speak fine. A bit louder, but we can hear you all right. Thank you.
Okay, yeah. Yes, I think it absolutely has to be addressed at a local policy level as well as at a national and European level. So we have our own resource and waste management strategy for Devon that Emma mentioned earlier, that has food waste prevention as one of the key elements. And it highlights what we want to achieve at a county council level, but it also allows others to hold us to account. So, you know, they can say, surely Devon County Council, you have got a policy to reduce food waste, and we can then show them our strategy at that local level to show that, yes, we certainly do have a policy. Our waste analysis, so we have analysed what's in the rubbish, the actual waste that goes to incineration. We've analysed what's in there across the county so that we know that 30% of that residual bin is food waste. And that really helps us identify that we've got to focus on food waste, not to just get it into the right bin, you know, into the food waste collection, but more importantly, to reduce it in the first place. And that also allows us to communicate to our residents and make sure that they understand the priority to reduce their food waste. We in Devon, we did actually have a food strategy that was written many years ago, but it sort of lapsed. And so we're looking at resurrecting a food strategy, which will look more widely at food production as well as food waste, and also highlighted through the COVID-19 food poverty, and also trade in the future. So it's wide ranging, but we're hoping that we can resurrect that strategy as well. We've also, I think it probably answers another question, so perhaps I'll stop there, because the fourth question is related to how we can cascade our own policies both up and down at a national and regional level. But perhaps I can pass on to someone else if you like.
Yes, sure. Thank you, Annette. It's interesting to see the way the Devon County considers the thing as part of the food policy, or maybe also as part of the waste policy. And that is an interesting debate to position the food waste within the overarching strategies of a regional authority. What is the case in the South region in France, in Provence, Alpes, Côte d'Azur? How is food waste included in the strategies?
Hello. In South region, food waste is included in the circular economy, but also we made a focus on this particular issue because if we stay in the global ID, projects won't be efficient. For us, fight against food losses is important, and it's in the first level of prevention. Just like Annette said, and we have a phrase in France with the agency of ecological transition agency is the better waste is the one that is not produced. And I think that we can apply this concept to fight against food losses. in the treatment of food, all the products have to be used and not throw away. And so it's the reason why we are working on that issue and with a particular focus, not just like one way to contribute to the objective of a mass plan, if you see what I mean. And we work on that issue at different levels because we are in a strategic level, and our partners have other competences to go further on that issue, and that's also the reason why we wanted to connect people with the network. But I think that we can talk about the regional network further in the afternoon. So for us, it's really it's not a point in a plan. It's really it's a real question, and it's une question à part entière. If you can help me for that word.
But by itself.
Yes, thank you.
Yes, well, it was very interesting to see how the region considers in its strategy the option of focusing and isolating a very precise element so that to be impacting that element. That was very interesting. Thank you, Diane. As time is running, and I want to keep time for the general interaction with the attendees, I will shift to the third question now. We heard this morning, it was Anne Rocheteau who mentioned the future of the programmation at EU level of the European Fund for Regional Development. As a matter of fact, in the actual programmation that is coming to an end, it is not that easy to see how the subject of food waste could be funded through the regional operation plan, due to the way the strategy is drafted, due to the way the action or the broad axes are defined. So, Pia, I know you have a nice experience on managing to use the regional operational program to tackle this issue of food waste. Could you tell us more about it?
Yes, thank you. at the moment, food waste is not very clearly spelled in our regional plan. Food sector in general, as you saw from my presentation before, is very important to us. And in the regional program or regional action plan, there is this sustainable food systems and new solutions for bioeconomy is sort of an objective we want to develop. And that's the one to which also EcoVest for Food project has been sort of attached to. So food waste is not, it's a bit of an old strategy, old program now, which has been updated and is updated again. So the awareness of food waste and what are all its connections and how it should be approached, it hasn't been in the awareness of the writers at the point when the present policy has been written. But I guess with this project and some others, it will be included in the next one, in the next edition during this and next year. Maybe not as a topic as such, but as part of circular economy. And that process has started now. and we have a wide range of regional stakeholders involved from different sectors, research, administration, education, businesses, of course, business developers, and so on. So it's now up to us to keep in mind that food waste is something we need to include there, but how specifically that will be remain open still. Thank you.
Thank you, Pia. So if the project can have contributed to this awareness about including this issue in the regional operation plan, it would be also a very nice achievement. I heard Konstantinos, that also in Western Macedonia there was an experience of embedding the food waste issue in the regional operational plan. Can you tell us more about it?
Yes, it was a topic that we were really interested in, to raise the awareness of not only of people, of the local stakeholders, but also from the part of, on behalf of the region, since the integration of local and regional policies and strategies, as well as the most important private initiatives to address and reduce food waste into a broader regional strategy or plan for the circular economy, which will include a specific access for food waste, could link this, all this could link to a local and regional policies and strategies, of course, to promote complementarity of actions and to avoid duplication of actions in national level. So what we really believe that we managed to do is to have a discussion on food waste policies that was never a policy instrument in our region. This is one of the main results that it's considered as an added value for the implementation of the project and the action plan, of course.
Many thanks. Would any other panelists want to add anything on this issue of the regional operation plan? Yes, Alfred. You have to unmute your microphone.
Sorry, can you hear me? Okay. Yes, about EADF, and also making a point about the coordination with other policies, etc., which has to be, it's a little bit all together. To understand the situation in Catalonia, we have to know that there are already existing policy instruments like the waste and resources plan, for example, to which we refer in the framework of the project, but also there are currently works about the circular economy roadmap, about the bioeconomy strategy, about the food strategic plan, etc. These are only some of the ones that will have to include in a certain way a coordination with our strategic plan on food waste, because we will have to avoid that there are any incoherence among all these instruments. So we are working on that, because as was previously said by Miriam this morning in her presentation, the action plan arising from the Eco Waste for Food project will become probably the strategic food waste prevention plan in Catalonia. So we will have to work further from 2021 and beyond, and therefore include the participation of all stakeholders, as I said previously. And this strategic plan on food waste, that is a mandatory thing that we will have to do, arising from our law that was approved on food waste prevention, food waste and losses prevention, on March this year, puts the effort on the preparation of strategic food waste prevention plan. Also, it's a law that covers the entire food chain and that includes prevention at source, not just the distribution of surpluses. So in this scenario, of course, food waste will have to be included in the new operational program concerning the ERDF. And yesterday I had the opportunity to have a talk with the managing authority to assure that food waste prevention will have a space in the next operational program. And this will be made easier because one of the cross-cutting axes of the operational program in Catalonia will be circular economy. So circular economy, which will be a horizontal issue, will have to cover all policies, will include also food waste prevention as one of the targets in the next operational program. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Very, very interesting. As Shen Wu said this morning, policies can be the best or the worst of things, depending on their relevance. And they are, in any way, they are impacting. So it's a huge responsibility to put our act together as regards the coordination of different instruments, so on and so forth. So that was a very good example that you provided here. Okay, the time is running fast, so I'm now going to the last question. It is about the connection, the synergies, and maybe the danger of overlap between policies at different levels, local, regional, national, and even EU level. And Annette, you had something to say about it previously, you told us.
Yes, thank you. I think what I mentioned is that it's important that policies and ideas get cascaded both up to government level and down from government level. So we now have a government resource strategy with targets related to the circular economy and the UN Sustainable Development Goals. So that's really good. Then they consult at a lower level to everyone who might be interested in the strategy. So we feed back, and we also feed back through representative groups, and then they refine their strategy and publish it. So the government are quite good at involving everyone in developing their strategy. And equally, sometimes local authorities are ahead of the government and may already be doing some things like collecting food waste and promoting food waste prevention. Here we have the court-ordered commitment 2025, which sort of links everyone in a way. Emma mentioned earlier that it's led by RAP, which is a charity, but they're funded by the government. And so they're very good at getting the partnerships together and also encouraging voluntary agreements rather than the law. So they've got 192 companies, including the Coca-Cola and the Tesco and the Lidl, to work together to reduce food waste with a target of 20% reduction between 2015 and 2025. And so we've cascaded that target into our own strategy. And that's what I wanted to highlight, really, that it's a matter of cascading information and policies in both directions in many ways. The government's also developing a food strategy, which picks up the point earlier, is it food or is it food waste? And how do they link together? Again, they're focusing on food poverty and redistribution, as well as nutrition and obesity and carbon. And just quickly going back to the previous question, we're very pleased to be working across the silos that we have at the County Council with our climate emergency team, who have highlighted food waste prevention as a priority, and also with our public health department. So that's sort of working laterally as well as up and down. It's important to work in all directions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Annette. It was very interesting, very illuminating again. Anyone wants to contribute on this question of the articulation, this cascading that is vertical, but also the lateral, the horizontal articulation between policy levels and strategies? Is anybody interested or want to contribute on that? Anybody else?
Maybe just 1 second, Alfred, to add that it is very important. We have done this way in Catalonia. We have worked together, different ministries from the Catalan government, so territory and sustainability, agriculture, health, social affairs, education, trade, etc. And this is the good way to tackle, I think, the situation, because it's a cross-cutting issue, cross-cutting topic. What we expect is also from national and, of course, from European administration is to also work all together, so that the EU agri policies, etc., all policies at European level take into account the food waste prevention issue. Because if not, there will be contradictions that are impossible to manage. Thank you.
Good point. I hope it will be heard where it should. Okay, so now...
And just one comment before you proceed to the... Since synergies are always critical, because sometimes we are talking about synergies in theoretical level and not in practice, what is considered in our region, especially as an important factor as to create synergies on this topic, is the real cooperation of public sector and private sector that is really interested in this topic and would like to develop their real needs on this topic. So we need to focus more on the private sector. Of course, if we have the policy agreement that we really need to work on food waste as a critical policy instrument of the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, including the private sector in policy prospects. That's of course very important. Okay, Samuel, have you been monitoring the questions? Are there questions? I give you the floor now for 10 minutes.
Yes, Pascal, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for this very useful panel. I have received, and maybe I guess you have seen this question on the right side of your screen from Elisabeth Mercier in France. It's a question for Michele in Italy. Michele, what do you think of the Italian network Spreco Zero? Did you and do you share with your colleagues in other cities in Italy about your experience? Michele?
Yes, I was just writing the answer actually on the chat and to Elisabeth and to all the other. We are member of the network Spreco Zero. We translated this zero waste, and we are member of the network, and we have shared with them some of the activities carried out with Eco Waste for Food, especially at the very end when we began working on the action plan. And so to define the actions, and for the final event in 2018, we have shared some good practices with them. And I remember in 2019 we went to Rimini during a sort of open doors for municipality, open days for municipalities and local authorities. And I've had the opportunity to talk about eco-waste for food. And I have presented a few of the best practices that the partnership has proposed in during the project. For example, yes, okay, Pesa e Pensa, but also how to use bread to produce beer. This is something very always very interesting. And then some of the network set up in France, a few of the app like Rescue app in Finland, the feedback I have received is that people are very interesting to learn about what other countries are doing, because with the aim of replicate the same in their own country, in their own area, in their own local context. So the methodology of eco-waste for food, which is the methodology of the Interreg Europe, is actually a very good one. And we don't have, as usually when we participate to the Interreg Europe days, and so is that we don't have to reinvent the wheel. This is something that we hear very often, and this is particularly true actually also with food waste, where a lot of experiences are scattered around Europe, and they are more or less aiming at the same stuff, and they all follow the same path. And so I had this opportunity in Rimini, as I told you, in October last year. Yes. And so within the Sprecot Zero network, which I hope will continue his work in the next years.
Thank you, Michele. It's very interesting indeed to see that the Interreg Europe methodology to organize a dialogue between the different stakeholders and the local authorities was very, very relevant and fit for the food waste issue indeed at municipal and regional level. And it's a second level, I would say, a second effect added value to the project indeed. There is another question, Pascal, from just a moment. I will invite a participant right now. No, I cannot, sorry. I will pick up another question. We have some comments, not question right now, but comments from Natalie Pano. She wrote that there are few success cases in Sweden that can be replicated as well. So Natalie, I invite you to write down some useful links for participants. Thank you. And there is also an invitation from Felicitas from the Thunen Institute in Germany to contribute. So she invites all the EcoWaste for Food partners to contribute to a next publication regarding the role of regional and national authorities regarding strategizing on food waste issues. Last check. Thank you, Natalie. Yes, there is a one hand is raised, but I cannot see on the chat. Please, could you write on the chat your question? Because
I cannot see a question any. From Dr. Eman Alamrouzi.
Yeah.
So I have admitted you, if I may say so. You can unmute your microphone and ask your question, Dr. Eman. No. Doesn't work. Sorry. Sorry, Samuel, I've interrupted you.
Mr. Alam Roussi, can you reactivate your mic, please? Or to write down your question on the chat, please.
Okay, are there other questions on the chat or raising hands?
No.
No, okay. Would one or several of our panelists say a last word before we close the session that was not said during the session and that would you would really like to share with us? Yes, Diane.
Yes, perhaps if we can have the, in few words, the point of view of a stakeholder who work with the local authority. It could be interesting because you ask us our vision of our role, but I think also if Julie can say in few words, why how she found interesting to work with us.
Yes, of course, really.
Yes. the project of the network that I'm the coordinator of, it's really interesting because it included local communities, associations, and some private companies. It's young, but because it has been created 1 year ago, but it has made collaboration possible between stakeholders who didn't know each other before, and that's really interesting because it's a project of the region of the local authorities. And it permit association, communities, private companies to meet in the same time to reflect, to exchange about food waste, about project, and work together. So so after just 1 year of experience, the network have. Real importance. We have already an online collaboration software to communicate information to the members of the network. And today, about 200 people use it. And now we are making webinars, guides, resources, and there is a dynamic actually with this network, but it's a long process.
Thank you for this example of stakeholders wanting to work within the frame of the regional policy or regional project. Okay, so we have terminated the time that was allocated to this session. Thank you very much, all of you, for your active participation and sharing your ideas and experiences. I think we made some useful comments, I hope. And now we are going to pause for half an hour and we'll resume the conference at 3 o'clock sharp. Thank you again.